Grant Virgin's family knew only a few details about his accident. A white car, a hit and run, a teenager airlifted from a bloody scene, nearly dead. They rushed to the hospital to find out if he was still alive.
It was a tough scene when we got there.
The doctor had a really, really bad look on his face.
That look was a reflection of Grant's injuries. They were staggering. His ER doctor told Grant's family to let him go.
The fact that this doctor wasn't fighting for his life just blew my mind. He's not dead yet. Why would you just, as a parent, how could you ever let go, not knowing that you hadn't done every single possible thing that you could for your son?
Doing every single possible thing was going to take Grant's family on a wild journey, full of twists and turns, and some unconventional therapies. 2 weeks after his accident, after several operations, Grant was in a coma. His heart was okay, his brain was not.
The doctor told me, she goes, okay, now we wait. Surely there's something we could do. She goes, nope, nothing we can do. We just wait. You know, the brain's got its own time schedule.
In what would become a theme, impatient, Grant's family swept aside that doctor's advice. First, they tried progesterone. That's a hormone that, according to early studies, may reduce inflammation in the brain. Soon afterward, his family says Grant began to speak. Then Grant's mother got an email with a link to this story.
He never would have come out of a coma if it hadn't been for the use of omega-3s.
The CNN story was about high-dose omega-3s found in fish oil and how it may have played a healing role in cases of traumatic brain injury. The first time this had ever been done, 2006, after a mining explosion. 12 miners died. Only one, Randy McCloy, survived. But his brain was badly damaged. His team of doctors, including Barry Sears, figured this. About 30% of the brain is composed of omega-3 fatty acids. Giving McCloy a large dose of fish oil, which is rich in those fatty acids, might restore function.
Yeah, I'd just like to thank everybody for their thoughts and prayers.
After the fish oil, McCloy made a dramatic, full recovery. The science is not clear. There have been no large studies, and it didn't always seem to work. But despite that, Grant Virgin's family, a combination of desperate and determined, decided to give it a try.
I don't want to wait 20 years while they do a bunch more studies to prove that it really works. I don't need that.
Grant was given 20 grams of fish oil per day through his feeding tube, even more than Randy McCloy got. In December of 2012, 9 weeks after his accident and only 2 days after starting high-dose fish oil therapy, Grant Virgin made a phone call.
It was unbelievable. A couple days into giving him the fish oil, he now is now talking in sentences.
In time, Grant became more animated, and soon he was walking.
Yeah, we'll do it starting with January.
January, February, March.
Here is Grant, a year after nearly dying, a year after his family was told to let him go.
Grant Wyatt Virgin, I'm 17. At some point, I'm going to be 18, but
He is doing everything doctor said he wouldn't.